Vadney back. Up to Esposito, one side in alone. Cheevers saves! Esposito behind everybody. Boat right in. Rob. And Cheevers made the stop. You would not believe that finish. Esposito walked in all alone, smashes his stick and breaks it as Jerry Cheevers stoned Esposito.
Well, the Bruins were extremely lucky there, Fred. Ray Bourque had the puck at center ice. He could have just wound down the clock by taking it in the Ranger end. He elected to shoot, and Esposito came through all by himself behind the defense, and Cheevers took it away from him.
Well, they're milling around there. I don't know what the temper's frayed. Nobody's thrown a punch, but instead of going to the dressing room, they're milling around. The only one who's gone to the dressing room is Phil Esposito. After Bourque had it, went for the empty net, blocked by Greschner. Somehow they fed Esposito from the blue line in, all alone, and Cheevers, what a stop.
He made a tremendous stop. Esposito took a stick and broke it over on the glass in about three pieces, but Jerry Cheevers stood his ground. Esposito moved in, pulled the trigger. From Esposito's point of view, he did not get it as high as he would like to have. But I'll tell you, well, we got a little thing going on here between Beaton
and
Secord. As the fans are now getting involved, as O'Reilly is out into the stands, and this is going to be something. O'Reilly's into the stands fighting with a Ranger fan, and all the Bruins are going over. Gilbert is in there, Peter McNabb. They're all into the stands. McNabb's going up to grab somebody about seven or eight rows up.
Well, this is too bad that after the game is over, it gets out of hand like this. And you got to worry about a spectator.
Well, the Bruins are at a decided disadvantage, Fred, with those skates, and somebody could get seriously hurt.
Oh, this does the game no good at all. The breakout, but they fail to clear the ice at the end of the game. And all the Bruins, it seems, are over the dasher and into the stands. Terry O'Reilly was first. They were battling, and just a wild scene at Madison Square Garden. Well, we're too far away. That's McNabb, I believe, at the top part.
I think I see Harry Sinden in that. I think Harry Sinden's over there with Freddie Creighton. They're getting the players out of there. Creighton is there. And Harry Sinden, the general manager, I don't know if you can see him. There he is in that. There he is.
There's
right
Creighton.
Behind Creighton is Harry Sinden, the general manager of the Bruins, as this thing has really erupted. Boston won the game 4-3.
And now the fans, I hope they're fighting amongst themselves now, and not... But players could get hurt. Fans, of course, too. But apparently... Well, why describe it? I wouldn't want to re-describe that scene. It was just a wild one.
Well, I think what actually happened, Fred, was this thing got going, and then Secord and Beaton were over against the glass and the boards, and there were fans standing down. Now, there you've got to understand that they're like they were standing here at Madison Square Garden on top of the boards, because that's where the platform is. And they reached down. One of them must have reached down and grabbed a Bruin or did something to a Bruin. Then he grabbed the stick and he started hitting one of the Bruins. I don't know which one it was. And then all of a sudden, pandemonium let loose, and all of the Bruins ended up in the stands. Well, here's the play coming up after Bourque took a drive and shot and missed. That's Vadney to Esposito. He lost it momentarily. Now watch Cheevers holding his ground. He moves down. And Esposito fired it, what looked like for the top corner, but he didn't get enough leverage on it, and it didn't take off the way he wanted it to, as Cheevers got his left pad on the shot and kicked it out.
Well, good job by Harry Sinden and Fred Creighton there, calming down the Bruins, getting them out of that melee in the stands with the fans, and finally peace is restored. And Dave Maloney and Medill are still arguing at center ice. And Medill, I've never seen this before. Here is after a game. Medill and Maloney's trying to get some kind of a penalty for that that will carry over.
Well, he's getting a misconduct penalty for sure because Medill indicated such. What else goes with it remains to be seen. But this game ended on a very sour note after.